Haunting songs and haunting drums. Headlamps and haunting skulls. Haunting dogs and haunting guns. Enough powder for haunting balls. Our hearts race to a hunter's call in weeping forest. The homestead echoes its call, the wasting and slumbering steps. In the darkness, when it shrubs, the dead rises to fill our ears with cries of the hunter's death. From the height of tall trees, lamentations descend, snowflakes, to drowse our agile feet back to one sleep. The wood crackles to our trampling. The tortoise withdraws into its shell. The squirrel throws nuts at us. The snail sighs in annoyance, while a python with swollen stomach looks at my machete, trembling eyes. Please spare my life, he cries. The cadaver you seek is bigger than the fellow in my stomach. The hunter lies in my liver. An unfortunate parrot came by my hole today, carrying this sad tale. He said, what fell the great leopard slayer lives among the villagers. Quivering eyes dared not stare, but I perceived evil marched through the forest from the distance you came. With ill will in the stench and grim in the shadows you play. The tricky frogs that reside in the lagoon by the Ogbono tree passed by my hole today. While stalking the hardened hearts out of this soft vegetation and singing as their tasty limbs thrust in the mouth of my bitch. Man kill man kill us, what do they love? If this cowardly tortoise would be so afraid, he will attest to the peril that he tells his coming home. But the tortoise quickly produces sticky appendages and deserts us in sluggish play. To whisper to the creepers and climbers, he calls to them, twisted things on the tall tree. Be as twisted as you, and he pleads, please wake the woodpecker to send the bees and the hornets after these menacing militants, who may are mild habitants, to sting them back to their home, to the bedplace of his homicide, so they don't blame the animals